Keratosis pilaris, KP, or chicken skin is a common skin condition that causes patches of rough feeling bumps to appear on the skin. The tiny bumps or pimples that you see are generally found on the upper arm, thighs, cheeks, or buttocks, and are actually dead skin cells plugging up your hair follicles. And in this video, we're going to look at what KP is, what causes it, a three-step easy-to-follow treatment plan for getting rid of KP, and three ways to prevent it. You don't want to miss this, so stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you've seen our son Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. This week's video is on keratosis pilaris, KP, or otherwise known as chicken skin. If you're new to the channel, I talk about health and wellness topics and try to bring as much value as I can to you guys, answer questions, and really build a strong community of people who just love healthy living. Smash the like button below now. There's a ton of useful information in here that I know you could benefit from. Also, while you're at it, hit that subscribe button too to stay up to date with new weekly videos. And without further ado, let's talk KP. When it comes to KP, the most notable symptom is the appearance. The bumps appearing on the skin kind of look like you got goosebumps or even the skin of a plucked chicken. And it's for this reason it's commonly known as chicken skin. It can appear technically anywhere on the skin where hair follicles exist, but you'll most likely see this on the upper arms. And it forms because you got all this buildup of keratin, which is a hard protein that protects the skin from harmful substances and infection. You need keratin to have healthy skin, but the keratin in KP forms a scaly plug that blocks the opening of hair follicles in your pores. The problem is you got so many plugs forming, which then causes patches of rough, bumpy skin. No one really knows exactly why you get all that keratin buildup, but things like genetics, having other skin conditions like atopic dermatitis, can be causes. And you'll typically see it in people who have dry skin, eczema, allergies, and obesity. Now enough background, let's get into the three-step treatment. The American Academy of Dermatology Association recommends a three-step approach to treating KP, and dermatologists recommend following this plan every day until you see clearer skin. So let's get started. Step number one, exfoliate gently. You can do this using a loofah or a rough washcloth to really remove all those dead skin cells off your skin. Daily exfoliation will help you remove the appearance of the skin, but just make sure that when you're exfoliating, that you're not scrubbing. Vigorous scrubbing can irritate the skin and aggravate KP, so when you're done, gently pat or blot the skin with a towel so that some of the moisture remains. Now we can move to step two. Apply a keratolytic product. What the heck is that? It basically is your version of a chemical exfoliator which causes the outer layer of the skin to loosen and shed. Look for products that contain any of the following: alpha hydroxy acid, glycolic acid, lactic acid, salicylic acid, urea, and retinoids, which I know a lot of you guys enjoyed my last video I did on adapalene, which I'm grateful for. I've left the best ones that I know for each of these in products in the description box below, so definitely check that out if you're wondering where to find these. Also, make sure to read the entire directions and warnings for each of the products before carefully trying them out. And if you're unsure, always ask your doctor or pharmacist before applying. Keep in mind that if you're applying too much or using more than needed, this can cause raw irritated skin, and if your skin becomes too dry or irritated, stop using the product for a few days. And for the third and final step, after you have exfoliated the area with your loofah, you've come out of the shower, applied your keratolytic product, you then want to slather on a moisturizer. Dermatologists recommend using a thick oil-free cream or ointment to help prevent clogged pores, and the key here is timing. You want to apply the moisturizer within the first 5 minutes of coming out of the shower when the skin is moist and hydrated so that we can seal the maximum amount of moisture, and then reapply the moisturizer when your skin feels dry up to 2 to 3 times a day. You should try to limit your showers to 20 minutes or less and avoid bathing more than once a day, as excessive bathing can dry out the skin. So there you have it, the three steps to beating KP. But wait, what if I do all those things and still get KP? Keratosis pilaris can be a very unpredictable and stubborn chronic skin condition, which is why you need to also have a maintenance therapy which involves preventing those annoying bumps. So for the first tip, I recommend using your moisturizer to not only treat the KP, but also prevent KP from returning, as it often flares up when the skin becomes dry or when the humidity outside drops. Moisturizers create a barrier between your skin and the air to seal in the water and rehydrate the top layer of the skin. So if you skip out on that, you won't be getting the full benefits of preventing KP from returning. There are moisturizers out there that contain lactic acid, salicylic acid, or urea that give you the boost to improve the skin texture. You can find them in the links I've left below too. Tip number two, avoid shaving or waxing the hair follicles in the area of the KP. This is because it can cause more bumps, so it's best to maybe cut down on that for a while to prevent those flare-ups. Tip number three, use a humidifier. Low humidity dries out the skin, so having a portable home humidifier or one attached to your furnace will add moisture to the air inside inside your home. Tip number four, avoid tight clothes. Wearing tight clothes can cause friction that can irritate the skin and can make the KP stand out more or worse. And for the last tip, tip number five, do not use perfume, soaps, or bathing products that could dry out your skin. And this can include certain bar soaps depending on your skin. Soaps that contain sulfates like sodium lauryl sulfate or laureth sulfate, SLS and SLES, they can disrupt the natural skin barrier that helps keep skin moisturized, which can aggravate sensitive and dry skin even further for some. This is especially true as some of them have high pH values that just dry you out. So opt for soap-free mild cleansers. I hope this video was useful to you guys, and I hope that you do share it with someone you know who could benefit from it. I also hope that you find relief from your KP symptoms. Like the video if you did enjoy, and subscribe to stay in more with all my other weekly health and wellness videos. Thanks for sticking tuned all the way till the end, and as always, thanks for watching.